Well, greetings from Palmdale, California, just north of Los Angeles, north of the San Bernardino Mountains, off the 14 freeway. Now, I always drive on this freeway when I'm headed up to the Sierra Nevada, and there's something that really makes my neck crank every time I go by here. And I don't have time to stop, and there's no safe place to stop. But today, I made extra effort to check it out. This arguably might be the most amazing, famous road cut in Southern California. Dare I say all of California? I don't know, I'll let you be the judge. But this road cut is spectacular. Okay, no rattlesnakes. Oh, look at somebody put up a nice velvet rope to greet me here. All right. Okay, no rattlesnakes. Now, it's gonna be a little loud because of the 14 freeway, obviously. But are you ready for the big reveal? Here we go. Whoa! Oh, look at that thing! Holy smokes! Look at that! Come on! You see like how you can't turn your head fast enough to catch everything, right, when you're driving. But you come up here and you get a nice view. All right, let's take a closer look. Okay, let's get our bearings here. This is the 14 freeway. North is this way. These are the San Bernardino Mountains, and the San Andreas Fault is at the running along the base of those, all the way that way. So this way up here is coming northwest. So the San Andreas Fault comes right through here. And look at, lo and behold, we have a nice sag pond right here. I think that's Lake Palmdale. Now, based on what I've read, you have a strand of a fault right here and another strand over here. So this road cut in the center is a pressure ridge. What's a pressure ridge, you ask? So glad you asked. A pressure ridge is created when you have two strands of a fault that are parallel. Now, these faults don't just slide past each other nice and easy, right? They don't just glide past each other. They're rude. They like push this way and push that way. So if you have two parallel strands that are sliding past each other, the land in the middle, this one pushes this way, this one pushes this way, and that land in the middle gets compressed and it's got nowhere to go but up. And that's what happened here. You have two strands that are kind of pushing each other and they have pushed up this ridge. This is called a pressure ridge. We might liken it to the freeway here, right? Like imagine you're driving on the freeway, like minding your own business, and you got these two big rigs that are coming aside of you, right? Oh, I gotta pay attention here. And then this one starts to kind of veer into your lane, so you kind of go this way, and then this one starts to veer. And they're just gonna compress you, right? And then boom, this guy hits you. You get mangled this way, and then this one hits you. That's exactly what happened here. Two big rigs, or the strands, compressed this. This is a complete car wreck. Look at it. You gotta remember, these sedimentary layers were originally deposited horizontal. Like, we're talking flat, okay? These are Pliocene in age, 2.5, 6.5 million years ago. All this was flat, all those layers. But those two rude big rigs just created this big wreck. And look at those over there. They used to be horizontal and they are completely opposite. They're vertical. And look at this guy over here. Look at it, it's like folded in on itself. This is a complete mess. This screams San Andreas Fault activity. Two strands vying for position and just creating this mangled mess. And it is simply breathtaking. Look at this. And we can fill in some details by reading this beautiful series, Roadside Geology. This one of Southern California by these brilliant people. And over here on page 311,
we see the large road cut goes through a pressure ridge in the San Andreas Fault Zone, exposing highly folded and faulted lake evaporites, siltstone, sandstone, and gypsum-bearing shale of the Pliocene and Averde formation. The main fault is at the south end of the road cut, a strand of the San Andreas Fault, and the Little Rock Fault lies at the north end of the road cut. Extreme deformation of the sedimentary layers is a consequence of being squeezed between two faults, I'll say. Well, thanks for joining me as we both hopefully appreciated this wonderful road cut we have here in Southern California. You know, it's really awesome when they ever make freeways or railroads. They do the work for geologists by cutting right into the earth and exposing the stories that lie underneath. And this is a dramatic story of the fault movement, the San Andreas Fault, and just these gnarled sedimentary layers where we get to see the action. And this is still moving, by the way. I got one more surprise for you. I'm gonna leave you with parting drone footage. Thanks again for watching.
I have learned to believe was and I have learned to hide. But I can't let what feels so wrong turn into what feels right. I'm walking through darkness, all I feel for real is light. Give me something to believe in.
Give me something to believe in.